Alright, so let's do the problem 56. This particular problem right here is a titration problem. And if you realize that acid, weak acid, is in a beaker, and then you're titrating it with NaOH, the strong base. So the curve should look like this. Oops, that's a little too big, but minimize this. So it looks like this. There is a small slope here, and then sudden change, and then flat region here. So here is what I want you to do. Let me just draw these things. So here is the equilibrium point. That's the equilibrium point. Equilibrium point. And anything before that. This region right here. Well, that's horrendous. Let me just try to rewrite this. Let me just try to write these things again. So anything that's here is a pure acid, pure weak acid. And then this point to this point, that is a buffer region. I call this as a buffer region. And then there is an equilibrium point. And then past the equilibrium point, and that's just a strong base region. So we're gonna calculate in a 1, 2, 3, 4 different way of actually calculating the pH. So let's do that one by one. So starting out with the weak acid region. So this one right here is just a pure weak acid. So what do I know, what kind of information do I have from the problem? Can I just write HA instead of the CH3COOH? That's HA. And volume is given. Volume is 44 milliliters, and then the concentration is 0.202 molar. Okay, that's in a beaker, right? And then you're titrating with NaOH. So what is the initial pH values? So let's just do the regular life stuff. So you have HA trying to become H plus, and then A minus, and then initial condition is 0.202. And then that's 0 and 0, right? And then X is given as 0.001. I always put it that way. And then the change is going to be minus X, right? Minus X. And then this is going to be positive X. And that too is going to be positive X. And then the current concentration is initial plus the change that represents the current conditions. So I do that for all of these guys except that one that doesn't do much. So that's addition of that. And then that one is addition of that, right? So that's that. Now, Q right here is actually given as a product over reactant. Product is this multiplied by A divided by HA, right? Then all current concentrations. So that's Q, and then K values. So now we gotta get something from the table, right? So the HA is actually CH3COOH, right? That's called acetic acid. I think pKa values, we can actually get that from the table. So let's just get that from the table. I think we actually use that one to sum around here. Yeah, the pKa value is 4.75. Where did it go? Yeah, 4.75. So, what is the Ka value? Ka value is equal to 10 to the power of negative pKa, right? So it's that one right here. So we want to change this value to this one by changing that. So let's do that one. So let me just try to highlight it with all the colors as usual. So this one is a reactant. And then these are the product, right? These are all unnecessary stuff, but it's just trying to make it looks better. Alright, so I just want to change this one to have this value by changing that one, right? So go to data, solver. So I'm gonna change this value to have the value of 3.1622. to the power of 10. E to the negative 10. Okay, so I got that. And then by changing X, right? And then option, and make sure that's 1 E to the negative 20. So all three pages looks like that. And just try to solve it. Awesome. So that's pretty much what I have. And that's the concentration of H plus. Right? That's the concentration of H plus. Let me just try to bold that one. So if I have the concentration of H plus in that way, let me just, you know, something just making it really strange. Why do I have 100 to the power of something? That's why. Yeah. Alright, so then just go back to this one. I knew that was wrong because see, this one right here, 4.75, it's close to the 10 to the negative 5, but it's for some reason I was just puzzled that I have some way off values. I'm sorry for the confusions. So I'm gonna repeat exactly what I did. So go ahead and do the solver. It's exactly the same Q values. To have the value of this one is gonna change 1.778 e to the negative 5, and then by changing X, right? And this one's supposed to be e to the negative 20, so it's good. Solve. Alright, so that's more like it. So that's the concentration of H plus. So concentration of H plus is right here. So pH right here is going to be equal to minus log, right? Minus log of that one right here. So it's going to start out with 2.7 2.244. That's a starting point. We are talking about right here. That's 2.7244. Okay, now one down, six to go maybe. All right, so let's do the second one. This is going to be a buffer. And whenever I actually work with a buffer, I want to know what region, up to what point I can use the equation for the buffer. That's Henderson-Hasselbalch equations. So to do that, I don't want to work with concentration. I want to work with a number of moles or number of millimoles. So I want to figure out exactly how much of the acid that I have at starting point. So volume is 44 milliliters, concentration is that. So I have volume times concentration, That's gonna give you number of millimole. The millimole is because that I multiply, not the liters, milliliter times mole, right? So that's how much I have, 8.888, right? So just try to write down a lot more in here. So I'm gonna insert that, I'm gonna insert this. Alright, so that's the number of acid, the number of mole of acid. Acid that I have. Now, and at this point, let's just think about what's going to happen if I add OH into it, right? If you have a weak acid, right? Let me just try to draw some pictures right here. If I have a beaker containing a whole bunch of HA, right? And then I put OH into this guy, right? Then that's gonna form H2O. That become H2O, and then I'm gonna produce A minus. So only thing that what I'm doing right now is that I'm gonna turn in HA into A minus every time I drop the OH minus, right? That's pretty much all I'm doing. So I'm converting the number of millimoles of the starting acid into the weak acid, a weak base, weak conjugate base. So let's calculate the number of mole, millimole of OH added. So just trying to put a little bit more space here. So millimole of OH added for this particular case, which is a 15.5 milliliters. So just try to give us a little bit more space here. Concentration for the base is 0.185 more, right? So number of millimole added is equal to volume times the concentration, right? That looks clean now, a little bit more. All right, so I'm just trying to put the insert here one more time. then millimol of A minus millimol of HA. So what do I have for the A minus? So initially at the starting point, we have a very minute number of the A minus here. So we can pretty much ignore that. So all of these things right here is all HA, right? And then I am going to convert 2.86 more millimol of that into A minus, right? So that's exactly that number. And then the leftover, the number is pretty much the HA. So that minus this is what I have for the number of millimol of A minus and HA. Once we got these two for the current number of millimol, then we can get the pH from the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. So the Henderson-Hasselbalch equations, I'm gonna copy this. Oops, where did it go? Should I paste it somewhere around here? Good enough. Then I have the pH of the solution is equal to pKa value, which is this one. And let me just highlight that one too. pKa, so equal pKa value plus log of, I'm using this formula, right? A divided by HA. So 4.427 is what I have. So the B, by adding 15.5 milliliter of the NaOH, the current pH is that. All right, let's do a C right here. C is gonna be, what's this, 20 milliliters. So I'm gonna change this to 20 milliliters. See, this is another beautiful thing about the Excel. You don't really need to do anything. It's already there. By just changing this, you automatically generate this. So it's 4.603, and then D, it works until this thing goes away completely, right? So 27.2 4.86. Oops, 4.8656. And then E. Now, E right here, this one right here is awfully close to these things right here. And using the Henderson-Hasselbalch equations, somewhere around here, is dangerous things to do, very close to the equilibrium point. So I want to actually use a different way of actually doing it. So what this one right here is very close to equilibrium point. So let me just try to figure out exactly what I meant by the, how I know that this is very close to equilibrium point. So the number of milliliter of OH needed to get to equilibrium point. So that's a question, right? That's concentration, the number of mole divided by the concentration is going to give you the number of millimol, right? Divided by the concentration of that, right? That's 48 milliliters basically. That's basically the equilibrium point, the place that we need to get to with the how do I say this? It's if you put 48.04 milliliters, then you are at here, right? And so 48 milliliters basically is at the equilibrium point. So anywhere between from here to here, the buffer equation doesn't work very good. So we need to actually work with a different approximations here. So what approximation is good? So let me just try to draw the picture here. So at the equilibrium point, right? You started out with all this HA. You have probably 3HA, for example. And then you put dumping like 3OH minus, right? Then HA is becoming A minus. This HA is becoming also HA minus. This A is also becoming H minus. So all of these are gone now. So what you really have right now is a pure A minus solution. So we have a pure conjugate base solution. That's what we have. So we're gonna use that formula right here. So let me just try to write out another Rice formula. Oops. And for this one right here, I have A minus is time become maybe that I should probably write the more complete formulas. A minus plus H2O. That's liquid, right? Let me just try to write liquid too. Then H is going to transfer from here to here to become this, and then that becomes OH minus. Right? So that's pretty much that. And then initial concentrations. Initial concentration is it's kind of funny because we have this many millimol, right? Because all of these guys are converted to A minus, but volume is different, right? What's the volume here? Volume is 44 milliliters plus 48 milliliters, right? So the volume at this at EQ is actually 44 plus 48, 92 milliliters, right? So what is the concentrations here? Concentration at the equilibrium is actually equal to this one is actually not so good organized, so I'm gonna actually put it in a different way so that you can actually see what I can actually do. So the concentration of this one right here, I'm gonna make it somewhere around here. Should I actually do? No, it's actually, I should probably make it somewhere around here. So concentration EQ is actually equal to number of millimol divided by the volume. So it's that one, right? So it's F5. So I'm gonna put these things to be equal to F5. So that's the concentration, initial concentration. This is gonna be zero. This is gonna be zero. And we don't care about that one. The X right here is gonna be 0.001. It's fine. And then this one right here is going to be negative x. And then this is going to be positive x equal positive x. And that one is also equal to positive x. And then the current concentration, this plus initial plus change.And then I repeat the whole process for the entire thing except that and that one. So let me just try to show you what I did. That. Right. Initial plus change on all of them, right? And then Q product over reactant is equal to product is that times this divided by this one.Right. Maybe going too fast. I'm just going to slow down a little bit. And then K value. Now, what is the K value here? If theAcid pKa was 4.75, if I recall, I think I put it somewhere around here, right? If the acid pKa was 4.75, then what is the conjugate base pKb here? The 14 minus.So 9.25. Then the K value right here is going to be 10 to the power of negative that one. So I want to actually change this value to get to that one by changing that one, right? So I'm going to do the data solver. I'm going to changethis value to have the value of 5.6234 e to the negative 10 by changing x right here. Then making sure that option have an e to the negative 20 and then I found the solution which is these guys, right?And OH, OH concentration is given. So I can get POH here. So this one right here is the concentration of OH minus, right? Then POH is actually equal to negative log of that guy.Then what is the pH here? Equal 14 minus this value, right? So that makes 8.8674. It's close enough. So this is at the equilibrium, so that's EQ right here. By the way, I'm gonna try to show you what happens if I actually predict this value at the using the Henderson-Hasselbalch equations. It's going to have quite a big errors. So if I were to actually predict the 48 milliliters, then I actually have a number of mole of A minus to be 8.88 and then the HA to be that, right?Then take a look at this, the pH value right here. pH value is 7.79, which is really different from 8.8. And that is actually a problem. And the reason is that anytime that you have you're working with close to the equilibrium point, right around here, Not that the slope is too big, but that you may actually get that the, by small changes, it's going to produce a huge errors. So, yeah, it's the walking it this way at the equilibrium point, I would say this whole red regions, you're better off with this things right here. And the, one of the possible reasons that, that it may be off is that the H2 also produce H plus and or H minus, and that's overwhelmingly larger than it actually affect quite a bit here. So that's part of the reason that this error is too big by doing this. So stick with this method right here at the equilibrium point. Now let's just try to go past the equilibrium point. We are now in this region right here, passing the equilibrium point. In this case, there are two possible ways of actually getting OH minus. Note that H plus is pretty much gone, right? Because you used to have HA, right? All kinds of acid, but acids are all converted into the weak base at this point, right? So there is no HA floating around, right? And from this point on, you're adding strong acid and strong base to the solution. Now you have two different base here. Strong base coming from the burette, and weak base that stays inside of the beaker. But remember that the weak base, 90% of those stuff, or the 99% of those stuff, actually stays in A minus. They don't produce OH minus. But strong base is gonna turn into OH minus 100%. So we can safely say that anything you add it, the strong base that you add it after the equilibrium point is basically the only source of the OH minus. So the equilibrium at the equilibrium point, that was 48 milliliters, right? And we are interested in 50.2 milliliters, right? 50.2 milliliters. Oops. So we are passed by how many milliliters? This minus that, right? 2.2 milliliter past the equilibrium. The concentration of NaOH, OH minus, just because the NaOH is a strong base, was 0.185 molar. So how much of the OH minus, millimole of OH minus, I have? Volume times the concentration. One is a milliliter. So I have 0.47 millimole of OH minus. That's the excess pretty much. So from this, I can actually get a pOH here. pOH is actually equal to negative log concentrations. Yeah, so let's just get the concentration first. So the concentration of OH minus is actually equal to number of millimole divided by the total volume. It's starting out with a 44, right? 44 plus 50.2. That's the total volume, right? So the concentration of OH is that value. And then get the POH. POH, yeah. That's equal to negative log of this guy right here. And then I can get the pH here. pH is equal to 14 minus that. So by just adding 2.2 milliliter of a base, the pH jumped quite a bit. 11.6355. Wasn't it? 6355. So basically, there you go. These are the list of the pH values at the many different points on the titration curve. I know I might have went a little bit too fast, but please pause the video anytime, and then that make sure that what you get is same as this one. Okay? Really, as long as you can calculate the pH using the right formula, for example, like right here, it's a pure weak acid buffer formula, pure weak base. And then anything from this point on is a strong base, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4. Four different way of actually calculating the pH. So as long as you know that, then you can actually do the problem.